Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is part 2 in a 3-part series I'm doing on creating a custom logo animation with some bells and whistles. Now in part 1, we animated an image, and we used text animators to animate 3 lines of text to get our base logo. If you haven't seen last week's tutorial, I highly recommend you do that now, especially if you don't have your own logo animation. Now, if you do have your own logo animation, last week's tutorial isn't necessary for you to understand the concepts we'll be going over today. In this tutorial, we'll be creating a really cool advanced reflection. We'll be using fractal noise, compound blur, a grid, and we'll be doing some fancy pre-comping. Next week, we'll be adding in some finishing touches, so make sure you return for that episode. You can take the tools you learn in each part of this series and apply it to your own projects to get a customized, professional result. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at Envato Elements. Check them out using the link in the description below and get 70% off your first month. Envato Elements has everything a serious motion graphic designer could possibly want or need. And you get unlimited downloads with your membership. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Once you sign up, you won't remember how you ever animated before having Envato Elements. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this video and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you learned from this episode. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the 70% discount from Envato Elements, and the project file for this series are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents, so you can go back and rewatch sections that you find difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. So in the previous episode, we created our logo animation. If you have your own animated logo, you can use yours instead and just follow along from this point. You'll need to bring your animation into your timeline, just as I have mine here, and then follow along with the rest of this tutorial. Now let's go ahead and grab all these, and we want to go layer, pre-compose, and we want to call this logo 1 and hit return. So this is our logo 1 and our logo animation. Okay, so let's grab this logo animation up here from our project panel and drag it down to create a new composition. And it's going to rename it Logo Animation 2. Command K, so that way we can change our comp settings. And let's rename that to Main Precomp, because this is the main precomp where we're going to be doing most of our work, and click OK. So let's make this logo animation layer 3D and maybe go forward so we can see it in its final spot. And let's duplicate that, so Control D. For the second layer, let's hit R for rotation and just flip that on the X axis 180 degrees. And then P for position and drag it underneath like that. And then let's just parent this bottom layer to the top layer. We can even rename this bottom layer logo reflect. I want to make one quick change in our logo 1 precomp. See how this isn't completely centered? I want to center that up. So let's go back into logo 1. Grab these bottom 3 layers and just parent it to the top layer and bring up your position and just move this over till it's about centered. So something about like that, and make sure that you unparent these. So it's just a good idea to make sure that your logo animation is centered at the pre-comp level. So that way everything stays centered in your final animation. So I got to our main pre-comp. Let's add in a new camera. Just click OK. And then let's add in a new null object and rename this null object camera controller. And we're going to make that 3D. And I always like to grab my camera controller and camera layer and change the color. It's maybe like yellow, so that way we know that they go together. Okay, so now we need to create our floor. So let's go up to Layer, New, Solid. And we're going to actually make this 4,000 by 4,000. And we're going to call this Floor Texture. And we're going to click OK. And now we need to pre-compose this layer. So go to Layer, Pre-compose. And we're just going to leave it at Floor Texture. Make sure you move all attributes. Click OK. And now we can go inside of this floor texture layer. Command K, so that way we can change our comp settings. So remember, we made the solid layer 4,000 by 4,000. So we want our comp to match that. So width 4,000, height 4,000. Click OK. And as we can see, our solid fits in here perfectly. Let's go to our effects and presets panel and just type in fractal. We want to add in a fractal noise. And we can leave most of these settings. The main thing we're going to change is our transform settings. And we're going to make that 400 on the scale. And then we need to make this layer 3D. And now I want to add a grid on top of this to look like tiles of a floor. So let's go to layer, new, solid, and make sure it's white. And we're going to call this grid and hit okay. And notice whenever you create a solid inside of a comp that's already created, it takes the dimensions of that comp. So this will automatically come in at 4,000 by 4,000. Okay, now let's go up to effect, generate, grid. Okay, now let's make a few changes to this. We'll change this corner point to width slider. And we want to change this width slider from 32 up to 400. Then make our border 30 pixels. And let's go ahead and make this layer also 3D. And then just parent our grid layer to our floor texture. And then pull up our rotation on the floor texture. And we want to rotate this on the X axis 90 degrees. So it's facing towards us like that. And now let's go back out to our main pre-comp. Now we can pull this floor texture down here to the bottom. And actually we can turn that off because this is going to be a map. And whenever I have layers like this that aren't being used in the way other layers are, I like to change the color to none. So now to create that floor, and I just clicked on logo reflect, so that way it will drop an adjustment layer right above it. So go to layer, new, adjustment layer. And let's call this reflection. With reflection highlighted, let's go up to effect, blur and sharpen, compound blur. And the only change we need to make to this is we need to set the blur layer mapping, so it defaults to the layer it's on, which is reflection, down to floor texture. It's using this floor texture as the map. And so we can't see it yet, so we need to make a few more changes. Go into floor texture, and let's just rasterize this layer, and then also make it 3D. And now if we change our active camera to top and turn this floor texture back on, we can see this is where it sits in our comp. Hit P to bring up our position. Just move the Z axis until it's about at the back of our comp like that. We'll say like negative 1500 pixels. And then go back to our active camera. On our Y axis, just pull this down until it covers that bottom logo reflect. So we want something where it covers it about like that. Make sure it's underneath the logo, but above the logo reflect. Now we can turn that layer back off. So now we can see that the floor texture is being applied to the reflection layer. Okay, so now we're going to animate this. Make sure that your camera is actually parented to your camera controller. So that way the camera controller, as you can see, is going to control the camera like that. At the 5 second mark, let's put a keyframe on Y rotation at 5 degrees. So slightly, or maybe we'll say 7 degrees. So that way it's turned like that. Go back to the beginning and maybe make it -7. So it's going to turn a full 10 degrees. And we kind of scrub through here. We see how that's going to look. We want to control the position of it using our camera. So with camera layer highlighted, hit P for position. And let's just scroll forward until we get it about full screen. Put a keyframe there. We can go back to where we can still see the logo. And let's just pull this back. You can do this setting however you'd like. I'll make mine about right here. So that's where the animation position will start. And just pull this keyframe back to the very beginning. And now let's right click on this second camera position keyframe, keyframe assistant, ease in. And I want to go to my graph editor and I want this to be like a hard ease in. So that way it comes in fast and then settles. However, I want my rotation, just right click on that, keyframe assistant, easy ease. The animation will come in quick, but it will continue to rotate slightly at the end of the animation. So see, you get this really cool reflection and you can see how these tiles in here, how they move with the camera, and it's like a really cool effect. It's something a little bit more advanced than just a blur, and you can actually change the way that this texture looks. So see, if we lock down this layer, just lock down the composition right here, and then we want to get it back into our floor texture. So double click on floor texture and then just drag this floor texture over to the right and then let's lock that down. Now make sure in your floor texture comp, you go active camera, make that top view so we can kind of see more what we're doing. And now see, whatever changes we make to this fractal noise is going to show up over here. See, maybe we want to make that block and then you can see the effect it has over here on the floor. And these options are basically limitless. You can change these to terrain and you can see how these just make the floor look different. You can uncheck your uniform scale and maybe you want to make this really super wide, but you want the height to be narrow. There's just any number of things that you can do and it's really up to your imagination. I'm just going to set this back to basic, linear, and 100% on both. But just so you know, you can change this fractal noise and that will affect the way that your floor looks. I'm going to close out this floor texture right here. And then I want to make sure this composition here is unlocked and go back out to our main pre-comp. So this is our final logo animation, and now all we need to do is add in our final touches, which we'll do in the next episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you learned from this episode. Come back next week for part 3 of this series. We'll learn how to add in some finishing touches to make our logo animation look professional and polished. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, to the 70% discount from Envato Elements, and the project file for this series are all in the description below. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.